Hi guys, so good evening and welcome back to my magical world. If you are new to my channel, I am Frostbite, and what I do here is that I read for you guys, like most of the times, and sometimes if there is something that is relevant to share with you, and with my life, with my, you know, current events and all of that, so I also share it with you guys. So if there is something that something that I'm excited to share with you, I'm going to share it. But the last time which I told you I'm going to tell you about it, we're still on the way there. But right now we still need to focus on this book again. So we have to finish it. We're almost done. Okay, so buckle up and we'll proceed. Wait a second. I'm just going to check something. Okay. Okay, so the next pages, so this is the title for tonight, guys. I just need to say that it, wait lang. Okay, so it's January 30, 2023, and currently it's 10:44 in the evening. Okay, so because I'm tracking things like this, I just want to make sure that it is today is the day. So okay, let's start. So God rejoices over you. This is the title. So one Sunday morning, the congregation of Eritsi Church had a stir. A man came in just minute before the service was to begin. He was dressed horribly in boots, dirty overalls, a flannel shirt, and a cowboy hat. The congregation was aghast, buzzing with concern. At the end of the service, the minister greeted the humbly dressed man and asked him if he enjoyed the service. The man said that he enjoyed it very much. The minister then asked the man to consider dressing differently and told him to pray to Jesus about how he would have him dress if he came back to the church the following Sunday. So the next week, the man returned. He was dressed the same, and once again, the congregation was disturbed. At the end of the service, the minister greeted the man and asked him what Jesus had said concerning his church attire. The man replied, "I spoke with Jesus about this, but he said he didn't know how I should dress for this church because he's never been here before. It's not how you dress your body, it's how you dress your heart. So you are not insignificant. Never view your life as if Jesus did nothing for you. Make the most of yourself, for that is all God made of you. The first and worst of all frauds is the betrayal of yourself. If you deliberately plan to be less than you are capable of being, you will bring unhappiness to the rest of your life. Too many people begin to do what God wants them to do because they are waiting to be able to sing like Sandy Patty, preach like Billy Graham, and write like Chuck Swindoll before they begin. God knew what he was doing when he put you together. Use the talents you possess. The woods would be very silent if the only bird that made any sound were those that sang the best, the very best. So you were created for achievement. You have been given the seeds for greatness. So what is greatness? What is achievement? Doing what God wants you to do and being where He wants you to be. So, here, the concept of this, guys, is like, I'm still, what do you call this, confused about this topic. So, I'm gonna repeat this part, okay? So, doing what God wants you to do and being where He wants you to be. So, we have free will, right? But, as crazy as it seems, there are also what you call this manifestations, which is partly you are, you know, in control as long as you do the universal law. Like this universe, the universal law, the things that this world demands or the universe demands. So it is still, I'm still confused on that part, the free will and the thing that is the path that you need to take, because that is what God wants you to go, or like that is where you were destined to be. So I still can't figure that shit in a way that is it will bind. Guys, I hope you know what I'm saying. Okay, so I can't express it thoroughly right now. So let us just proceed. So, Christians are new creations, not rebuilt sinners. Don't ever forget that God calls you friend. What an incredible statement that is. He also says you are wonderfully made. You are beginning to see that God made you special for a purpose. He has a job for you that no one else can do as well as you. Out of the billions of applicants, only one is qualified. Only one has the right combination of what it takes. God has given each person the measure of faith to do what he has called him to do. Every person is gifted. A person is never what he ought to be until he is doing what he ought to be doing. So God holds us responsible not for what we have been. God holds us responsible not for what we have, but what we could have. Not for what we are, but what we might be. I'm sorry for the dog. I don't know if you could hear that, but it's loud. We are responsible to God for becoming what God has made possible for us to become. I'm really sorry for the dog. Your life makes a difference. There are no unimportant people. Although we are all different, no mixture is insignificant. On Judgment Day, God won't ask me why I wasn't King David or George Bush, but why I wasn't John Mason. So Jerry Van Dyke said it well. The best rose bush is not the one with the fewest thorns, but that which bears the finest roses. So that is so cool. I like the end part. So yeah, that's a bit amazing. So okay, so that was it, guys. It's short, but it's sweet, right? So I didn't do much today, but I actually did. I did some errands. Yeah. So I can't. I'm kind of stuck a bit. So I don't know, you know, the direction that I'm going to go is still, I can't tell you yet because I don't know too. So anyways, guys, okay, so we're done. So thank you guys for listening, and you don't give up. Like, let's not give up. Okay, so it doesn't really matter If you think you're not doing it right, you're doing it right as long as you keep going. Okay, so it doesn't really matter. It won't make sense today, but I know that in the future it will. Okay, so thank you guys for this wonderful evening with you, for listening. You know, it's important for me that. What I mean, guys, is that it makes me feel good that you are here with me, you know, in my journey. So, yeah. Thank you, guys, for listening, and thank you for helping me make this world a better place for all of us and for the future generation. I don't have much to say, but yeah. Stay healthy, guys. So, it's evening already. Let's have a good night. Hi. The calmness that's around me. I feel feeling down when you're not around. Galing sa kalikasan, laging iniiwasan. Ng iyong aroma'y madalas na kinaaadikan. Amoy ng iyong damo, taglay na ganda mo.